welcome to the newest video for my YouTube channel, the newest edition of News and Views. It would seem more and more people are now starting to cooperate with the United States House of Representatives' investigation of Donald Trump concerning the House's impeachment inquiry. Now, a member of Trump's administration, Gordon Sondland, who is the United States ambassador to the European Union, recently contradicted Trump's claim that his call with the Ukrainian president Volodymyr Zelensky was not about quote-unquote quid pro quo. This puts Trump into more danger of seeing his time in office ending prematurely at the hands of a possible House impeachment, as well as a possible Senate conviction, should a secret vote be held, which some 30-something Senate Republicans said they'd be willing to use to vote to convict Trump. Now, earlier this month, on November the 5th, several elections were held here within the United States. Some of those elections saw Democrats retaking certain political offices in major Republican states, such as it being thought back around that time that Democrat Andy Beshear had defeated Trump-endorsed incumbent Republican Kentucky Governor Matt Bevin to become the state's new governor. Well, as it turns out, Bevin initially refused to concede, wanting a re-canvassing. Even though a hypothetical re-canvassing effort that took place shortly afterwards showed that Bevin was still trailing behind Beshear, as well as saying that the decision should be left to the state's legislature, which is currently Republican-controlled. And, of course, it was speculation that if that had come down to that, Republicans would have likely attempted to steal the election for Bevin, as well as calling out Kentucky's Secretary of State, Democrat Allison Lundergan Grimes, on account of voter fraud. Now, during the time that Bevin refused to concede, Kentucky's Senator Mitch McConnell, who is also the United States Senate Majority Leader, admitted that Beshear was likely to become Kentucky's next governor. Now, as of fairly recently, however, Bevin recently finally conceded the race for Kentucky's governor, making Beshear's status as Kentucky's new governor-elect official. Democrats have now taken complete control of the Virginia state government for the first time in I don't know however many years. Julie Briskman, the cyclist from Virginia who became famous for flipping off Trump's motorcade, I believe a picture that was taken of her doing so even made the news, defeated a Republican to win a seat on the Loudoun County Board of Supervisors. Now, with so many wins during this year's elections on November the 5th, most on social media have called this the quote-unquote blue wave of 2019, saying that politicians like Kentucky Senator and the United States Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell should be feeling very scared of the results, as it indicates not very good odds for Republicans heading into next year's elections. Now, according to an article in The Hill, it is being claimed that Democrats are aiming to impeach Trump just before Christmas of this year. Now, that's, still to be seen whether or not the impeachment would actually happen before the end of this year, or if it's possible that it might not actually happen until maybe the early part of next year. As it currently stands, there are more than enough Democrats for an impeachment vote to be successful in the House. Senate Majority Leader and Kentucky Senator Mitch McConnell has claimed that if it came to a conviction hearing in the Senate, Trump would most likely be acquitted. However, that contrasts with what former Arizona Senator Jeff Flake claimed, where Flake stated that if a secret vote were to be held in the Senate, some 30-something Republican senators would vote to convict Trump. Those 30-something Republicans, combined with all 40-something Senate Democrats, which in total would equal, 70-something, would end up proving Trump's conviction in the Senate quite likely, despite Mitch McConnell's claim. In quite the interesting announcement that was made recently, Republican Representative Peter King of New York's 2nd Congressional District has said that he will not seek re-election. Rather, King has announced his retirement from Congress. King's announcement now brings the number of Republican representatives having announced either no bid for re-election or going into retirement to a little over 100, which of course greatly diminishes Trump's power within Congress. Now, within like the last few days or so, the former United States ambassador to the Ukraine, Marie Yovanovitch, testified before the House Intelligence Committee. She more or less has confirmed that a lot of what Donald Trump has said recently is indeed lies, which does not bode well for Trump. Now, it is also made news that Trump recently had a surprise medical exam at the Walter Reed Medical Center. Some are speculating that it may concern a possible health risk for Donald Trump, with some even going so far as to claim that he could use the surprise medical exam as an excuse should he attempt to resign from office before the House impeaches him. What that means is that I don't know if maybe he could claim that during the exam that the doctor found out that all the stress he's been going through because of the impeachment has taken its toll on his body to the point of where maybe he might claim that the doctor says that it's gotten to the point where his body can't take much more of it and that he needs to depart from the situation that he's currently in. And of course, another interesting piece of news that has recently popped up is that it is looking more and more likely that Donald Trump's running mate, Mike Pence, has pretty much known a great deal of what's been going on recently, which implicates Pence right beside Trump, meaning that if Donald Trump ever does go down, it's possible then that the same might happen for Pence. And now in other news. On the series premiere of Friday Night SmackDown on Fox, now former WWE Champion Kofi Kingston faced off against then challenger and now current WWE Champion Brock Lesnar. Now, within a matter of seconds, the match ended, with Lesnar having defeated Kofi Kingston by pin after executing an F5 on Kingston to regain the championship and become WWE Champion once again. Now, afterwards on social media, wrestling fans called out WWE for the seemingly bad move made by the company, with quite a few comparing it to the infamous finger poke of doom executed by WCW by Hulk Hogan and Kevin Nash during an episode of WCW Monday Nitro that was aired back in the 90s. WWE was also called out for the fact that when Rey Mysterio showed up on the premiere with now retired MMA fighter Cain Velasquez to confront Lesnar, Lesnar displayed a very visible face of fear upon seeing Velasquez, and in doing so, made all of WWE's contracted talent that Lesnar had previously faced look weak. Now, of course, to kind of make the whole situation kind of a bit worse, when Velasquez and Lesnar met face to face at the Crown Jewel event in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, where Lesnar was defending his championship, Lesnar ultimately ended up with the greater hand, defeating Velasquez with the Kimura Lock armbar, warranting even further criticism against WWE. Now, at the time back then, many social media users stated that in anger, they would no longer watch WWE programming, with almost all stating they would boycott the Wednesday night USA Network broadcast of WWE's developmental territory, NXT, choosing instead to switch to watching All Elite Wrestling's Wednesday night show, Dynamite, on TNT. The National Wrestling Alliance, under its new owner, Smashing Pumpkins frontman Billy Corgan, through his company, Lightning One, recently announced that it would start airing a weekly program called NWA Power on both its Facebook page and YouTube channel. Well, NWA Power debuted on October the 8th at about 5:05 p.m. Central. It would seem it's a way for the NWA to start branching out to new fans without the risks associated with securing a broadcast outlet and time slot. WWE recently announced the premiere of its studio show on Fox Sports 1 called WWE Backstage, which debuted earlier this month on November the 5th at 10 p.m. Central. On the show's series premiere, current Universal Champion The Fiend, Bray Wyatt, showed off his custom Universal Championship belt, which displays the logo of The Fiend, The Fiend's catchphrase, "Let me in," and a picture of The Fiend. Now, on a much more recent edition of WWE Backstage, former WWE superstar CM Punk showed up. Now, it has been reported in multiple outlets, well, wrestling news outlets, that Punk will be working for the show as a special contributor. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is about it for this video, for this edition of News and Views. As always, I would like to thank all of you for tuning in to this video, as well as for tuning in to my YouTube channel. So, until next time, as always, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and until next time, everyone, as always, have a great day.